Anosmia is a condition when you lose your sense of smell. It affects 6 million people in the United States every year. Losing your sense of smell or anosmia can be quite debilitating. For instance, if you're a cook, you may not be able to get that exact taste right. If you're a mother, you may miss a dirty diaper, but anosmia can be dangerous for everybody, especially if you have a fire, you can't smell the smoke, or a gas leak, you may miss it. There are many different types of smell disorders or olfaction disorders. The number one is complete loss of smell, which is called anosmia, or you can have a decreased sense of smell, which is called hyposmia, or you can have a really different type of disorder where you have a change of smell, where you may smell something, but it smells like something else. This is called parosmia. Often associated with your sense of smell is your sense of taste, and that's called ageusia. And 80% of people who have lost their sense of taste is really associated with their loss of smell. In order to understand olfactory disorders as well as changes in taste, the first thing is to understand the anatomy. Whenever you smell anything, the particles first go through your nostrils up to the very top of your nose. Here there are nerve fibers that goes directly into your brain, so the pathway is actually very simple. If you have disruption of this pathway, either by your nose being blocked or damage to the nerve cells, this is what causes different problems with changes of scent. Taste is incorporated because when you eat something or drink anything, there's a pathway behind your throat that actually leads to your nose called the nasopharynx. So when you're eating or drinking and tasting food, the particles are actually going up to your nose and contributing to your sense of taste. Once you understand the anatomy of the nose, the reasons of anosmia become more obvious. The number one reason by far is nasal obstruction. Whether it's from a cold, from a virus, or perhaps from a nasal septal deflection, you may have polyps. The second most common cause of anosmia is actual damage to the nerve caused by viruses or other types of infection. And with COVID, that's become an initial presentation for a lot of people who lose their sense of smell and taste. There are also many less common reasons for anosmia, including toxins, medications. Sometimes we may find different types of tumors, including cancer, although that's very, very rare. The workup for anosmia is actually fairly simple. The first thing we'll do is we'll look. We'll put a small camera into the nose and see if there's anything that might be obstructing. The second thing is obtain a CAT scan or an X-ray in order to see the tract from the nerve as it goes into the brain. Once the workup is complete, we focus on treating the underlying cause. If you have nasal obstruction, then it may be as simple as treating your allergies or taking out polyps or straightening out your septum. If we suspect that it may be caused by an infection, then we may suggest different types of medications, including corticosteroids that reduces the inflammation of the nose. There are also different types of over-the-counter medications that may or may not have some benefit. This includes taking zinc and vitamin A. Some studies have shown that even acupuncture has had some benefit. Another potential treatment option is called olfactory training or smell training. We cover this in depth in another video, but what it is a method where we introduce different common sense so that your brain can be redirected to learn how to smell again. Anosmia can be very, very frustrating for patients. It's important that you not only recognize the cause, but treat the underlying condition first. I'm Dr. Raza Pasha. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want more information on anosmia, go online to PashaMD.com. Otherwise, we'll be glad to take care of you. Schedule an appointment with us at our clinic. Hello, everyone, and thank you for watching our video. I hope you found it useful. If you liked it, please subscribe to our video channel. That way, every time we post a new video, you'll be informed. Also, if you're interested in our social media, we have a link in the bottom right-hand corner.